Do you know what geometry means? Geometry means earth math. Geo is one of the words in Greek for earth, and then that root means math, like the word geography. Geo is earth, graph means description of. So literally geography means the description of the earth. We need to talk a little bit about geometry. It's not difficult geometry, it's actually relatively easy geometry, and much of it you've probably encountered before. This is a circle. We define a circle by the number of degrees that it has. Do you know how many degrees there are in a circle? 360 degrees. That's correct. Do you have any idea where that comes from? This comes from the ancient Babylonians, believe it or not, where they would look up in the sky and they saw the sun and they saw the moon and they saw these as disks. They believed that the earth was also a spherical ball-shaped object because they worshiped these things. And what they figured out, lo, those many years ago, was that there are 360 days in a year. There are, of course, 365 days in a year, but honestly, I don't know if 5,000-6,000 years ago, if I would have been able to calculate that there was 360 days in a year. If you saw the Tom Hanks movie, Castaway, you know that he's in that cave calculating the days so that he can make himself get off of that island. So I'm saying degrees. We use a shorthand instead of writing degrees over and over. Like if you went outside and it was 67 degrees, you probably wouldn't write the number 67 and then D-E-G-R-E-E-S afterwards. The shorthand for degrees is that little circle right there. Anytime you have a number and you put that little circle next to it, it means degrees so that we do not have to write degrees over and over and over. This is an angle. Can you see that? This is a 90 degree angle. That type of angle has a name. Do you know what it's called? It's called a right angle. That means this, that we can divide a circle. And a circle can be divided into four equal 90 degree right angles, as you see here. Here's 90 degrees. Here's another 90 degrees, which makes 180. There's another 90 degrees that makes 270. And then here's another 90 degree angle, a right angle that makes 360 degrees. This is a line, but a line is also an angle. Do you know how many degrees there are in a line? A line makes a half circle, which has 180 degrees in it. So you can see that a circle can also be split into two equal 180 degree angles. 180 degrees plus 180 degrees equals 360 degrees, or a circle. Now, we can also subdivide degrees. Think about a clock when we do this. Remember, clocks, at least originally, were circular things. A clock has three units to it: hours, minutes, and seconds. The largest unit is hours, the smallest unit is seconds, and then minutes are in between that. 1 hour has 60 equal minutes. 1 minute has 60 equal seconds. Okay, we're in agreement on this. We use the exact same terminology to divide a degree, with one exception. So think about it like this. What we're doing is something along this line. If a pie just came out of your oven and there were eight people in the house and you wanted to divide it equally, you would split the pie into eight equal pieces. If you got your piece and then four more people arrived at your house and you had to split your piece of pie, you would split it into four more pieces. And then if several more people came, each of those people would have to split their pie. What's happening is you're making the piece smaller and smaller and smaller. Well, with regard to this, ultimately we are going towards latitude and longitude. And the idea is to get to a very specific place on Earth, just like a clock is designed with time to get to a very specific place in time. If you and I agreed to meet between 2 and 3 o'clock in the afternoon, and I arrived at 2 and you arrived at 3, that's not very specific. But if we say 2:15, that's getting very specific. And 2:15 and 28 seconds, that's exceptionally specific. This is what we're going to do. We're going to divide degrees up in a similar way to the way we divide up time on a clock. What we're going to do is switch out the word hour and put in the word degree. So if you look at that second bullet point, hours, minutes, seconds, take away the word hours, slip in the word degree. And the same thing with the third bullet point where it says hour equals 60 minutes, take out the word hour, slip in degree, and now we will have our terminology. The terminology is the same, although we are describing something different. So, 1 degree, remember we just took out the word hour, we slipped in the word degree, now we're going to divide it exactly the same way, equals 60 minutes. That's correct. And the shorthand for minutes is that little hatch mark right there. So instead of writing the word minutes, we put that little mark there. Just like for degrees, we put a little circle. 1 minute is divided into 60 seconds. That's correct. And the shorthand for seconds are those two little hatch marks, like the thing for that we use for inches. So that means that 1 degree equals 60 minutes, and 1 minute equals 60 seconds.